Welcome to today's head-to-head press conference to talk about this weekend's World Championship Boxing here in Manchester Arena. It's brought to you by Frank Warren in association with Top Rank and Banner GH3 Promotions and proudly sponsored by Coral and Raynham Steel. This build is World War III. I think you'll agree we've got some fantastic fights on the card. And some of the amount of 50-50 fights on here, I'm sure it is going to be all out war and full of explosive action and toe-to-toe fantastic fights. I'm going to run through what we've got on the table and quickly run through the fights that are on the card, and then you can ask the headline fights to say a few words and then open the floor to some questions. Just starting on the lower table, we've got from left to right, John Kayes, Jimmy Kelly, Craig Evans, Luke Blackledge, Jack Catterall, Majinder Singh, Sonny Whiting, Jaro Brutakanen, Lee Markham, Tom Stalker, Martin, Fidel Rios here with us yet, if not, let's hope he turns up Saturday, and Adrian Gonzalez. And on the top table here, we have Mark Abrams, Vito Milinetti, Dennis Porter, John Thompson, Joel Diaz, Diego Magdaleno, Terry Flanagan, Steve Mallet, Liam Smith, and Joe Gallagher. Just running through those names, I'm sure you'll agree with me that this is an array of top talent. The Northwest is a breeding ground for fantastic fighters, boxers, trainers, and fight fans are in for a real treat with the card that has been put together for Saturday. It's not often you get such fantastic fights all on one card, so I'm anticipating a fantastic night's evening, and the fans are in for a real treat, both in the arena and for all those that will be watching live and exclusive on Box Nation. Just to run through the fights individually, get through that. We've got a Dale Coyne and Jack Flatley fighting, and then I've got a real exciting guy making his debut, Majinder Singh, who's turning professional after a highly decorated amateur career. He's come over from India. He was the absolute star and apple of India's boxing eye. He's in fact the apple of the sporting eye in India. He's to put it bluntly, he's a superstar in India, and we are absolutely delighted that he's decided to turn professional with Queensbury Promotions, and even more delighted that he's decided that he wants to make his professional debut in the UK. He's based himself here for his training camps, and he's set up with Lee Beard and the top team that he's got around him, with Roon and the other guys that are on these two tables. He's learning every day, and I cannot wait to see him make his debut. He's been over here for around about a month. You can see the vast improvements that have been made. Still a long way to go, obviously, but he's hoping that Saturday will be the first step to the road to glory, and he can hopefully mirror it, which is what he did in the Olympics, and then on the World Amateur Championship, the Commonwealth Games, the Asian Games, all of which he's medalled at. But obviously we've got a guy to Virginia's right, Sonny Whiting, who's coming up to, hopefully for him, to spoil the party. It's going to be a tall order for Sonny, because Virginia has got massive power in both hands and fantastic movement and footwork. So I applaud Sonny for taking the challenge. Sonny's got a winning record, so Virginia's got it all to do, but it's going to be a fantastic fight. Well, Ryan Burnett, unfortunately, couldn't be here today, challenging for the vacant WBO European Bantamweight Championship. Ryan saw that last time in Belfast. Looked terrific, and there's a lot of high hopes for Ryan in the coming season. With the vacant WBO Intercontinental Lightweight Championship between Adrian Gonzalez and John Kayes, as I said, Adrian's with the same gym as Virginia, being trained by Lee Beard, and he's I've watched a lot of his sparring, and he's one of the most dogged and determined guys in the gym. Works incredibly hard. Usually has a smile on his face, but with this camp, I think he's seen a slightly darker side to him, which has actually been quite an interesting thing to see going in and out of the gym and seeing him in a couple of days. And this is a real grudge match against John Cowles. Both local lads, and both of them have got points to prove, you know, who's the best in the area, let alone in the country. So, you know, winner of this, I'm sure, within the next season, will be going on to fight for at least British title level. But, you know, it's a ranking fight, and, you know, when the best man win, I believe it'll be Adrian, and it's going to be another top fight, another one. Jimmy Kelly decided to sign with Greenwood Promotions, and we're looking forward to seeing him on Box Nation. He's been slightly under the radar since turning professional, but you know, he's wrapped up a 15-0 record, and he's boxing for the vacant WBO Intercontinental Super Welterweight Championship. So we're looking forward to seeing what Jimmy's all about, and looking forward to seeing him hopefully again progressing in the coming season. But you know, he's got to overcome a tough Argentinian, as we saw last weekend. They are as tough as they come, the Argentinians. So Jimmy's got it all to do, and I wish him all the best on his Box Nation debut. The vacant WBO European Lightweight Championship has been contested between Tom Stalker and Craig Evans. Again, fair play to both guys for taking the fight, both Queensbury fighters. Craig coming off a bit of a disappointment against Scott Cardle. I'm sure he can kick himself. He knows he's better than that one than he was on the night. But, you know, anything against Tom Stalker, who everyone knows has got undoubted quality, fantastic boxer. And again, it's a real interesting fight, that one. Commonwealth Super Middleweight Championship between Luke Blackledge and Lee Markham. Luke Blackledge, as we all know, tough as they come, we won't leave anything in the ring. Turned up today with a fantastic smile on his face, and I know he's looking forward to it. And Lee, absolutely, you know, boxed out his boots against Frank Maglione, and managed to get, he got a well-earned draw against Frank, and as we saw, how dogged and determined Frank was last a couple of weeks ago against Chilinov, that is a real result for Lee, and I'm sure he's out to show that wasn't just a one-off, and that he does, you know, he doesn't belong in that sort of company. So another good interesting fight. Young man, Jack Cattrall, will be fighting for defending his WBO Intercontinental Super Lightweight title against Jarkko Kultinen of Finland. Both 12-0, both very, very talented guys. Jack, for me, is one of the rising stars of world boxing, apart from Lee Beach Gym, and you know, he's one to watch, and everyone keeps saying a bit about how excited he is and what he has the potential he's got. And it's down to Jack to go out there and show us what he's capable of fulfilling that. But obviously can't take it off the ball. Anyone who's confident enough to come over to Finland, challenge someone like Jack, who has got a 12-0 record, has to be taken seriously. So, it's a very, very interesting one. Back to the first of our two world title fights. For the vacant WBO World Super Welterweight title, we've got Liam Smith from Liverpool taking on John Thompson from Newark, New Jersey in the States. I don't think there's much more that can be said about Liam Smith than hasn't really been said. He's probably one of the most naturally talented fighters out there, and has asked to be stepped up in the level of opposition time and time again. He's the only guy who I've seen knock people out and still not be smiling and feel like it's been the right result or the right fighter. And even though he's looked fantastic doing it, I think he knows he wants to be tested himself. There's no better platform to do that than against someone such as John Thompson for a world title. It's the next step for Liam. Under Joe Gallagher, every time he gets in the ring, he looks like he's improving. He'll have to be at his best on Saturday if he wants to a world title in his waist. But you know, we all know that he's very capable of doing that. But I'm sure John will have his say and hope that he's taking that title back to the States. The second world title fight of the night sees Terry Flanagan defend his WBO World Lightweight title, which he against Diego Magdaleno from Las Vegas. Again, it's a top level fight. Terry, I think, would have been on top against the Cepeda had that fight not ended as it did. But this is Terry's chance to show that he really does deserve to be a world champion. he's a worthy champion, and it's a very, very tough first defence. But you know, this is world level boxing, and there's no easy fights. But it's, it is another 50-50 fight. But Terry seems to thrive on that, and again, made the best man win. But I've got a strong feeling that that title will be staying here in Manchester. Well, take a breath now. But just like I'd love to ask all the guys to say something, but being quite a while, so I'm just going to ask the two world title fighters to say a few words, starting with John Thompson, then to Diego, and then to Terry. So, John, if you want to say a few words, thanks.
How you doing, everybody?
All right, bro.
I look forward to this opportunity of, well, it's more an opportunity. It's both coming back to America.
Amen.
Sorry to say, this will be the last time y'all see this film. But, you can follow me on Instagram and watch it. I don't sleep with that night. Official_ApolloKid. That's kid for 2 years. I've been doing this right here for 22 years. I'm 26 years old. You know, I came over here for one reason only. And that's to come get my belt.
Enough said.
I'm okay, hey.
Enough said.
James Smith, please.
Is all right, everyone? Follow me on Instagram. I've just done look forward to it. I'm privileged to be on a good card. And, what you're looking at here is one of the best cards of the year at the minute. So, I'm delighted to be on it. And so I have the card. So, we've done everything in training. So I've seen enough of John Thompson to know, I'd say about my best, I beat John Thompson, so I'm looking forward to the current meet, and I think we'll have a new world champion Saturday.
Excellent.
Yuji Liu.
So the challenger for the WBO Lightweight Championship, Diego Magdaleno.
Thank you for having me, everyone. I'm here from a long ways, from Las Vegas, Nevada, but training with the coach throughout the years in India. I have a great support system and a huge team behind me. There's nothing that's going to stop me from getting that title. I've worked hard, the hard work's done. We're here to get the title. We're here to fight, one thing's for sure. The fans will be happy. This is a fan-friendly fight. I think, you have two badass guys going up for a title, and the best man's gonna win. I put in my all into everything, into this fight. Everything that from my amateur background to my professional history has all led me up to this point right here, and there's no turning back. My eyes on that title, and there's no doubt in my mind that I'm not gonna go home with the. With the world title, to my home country. So this is something I'm looking forward to, and I'm very, very, very proud to be up here and show everyone my capability. And huge thanks to all the promoters out there, Top Rank, Frank, thank you as well. My opponent, thank you for taking this fight. This is gonna be one hell of a ride, and. I'm looking forward to it, so thanks to everyone, including my team, and Frank Espinosa also. Right on, guys.
Terry Flanagan.
Yeah, I'd just like to say thanks for everyone coming out and everyone on Saturday night. It's going to be a great night of boxing. Two great fights, world title fights, the longest, as well as the undercard, which is a great undercard, and yeah, I'm looking forward to putting the best performance on, best career performance on. It's going to get a stoppage.
Sounds good. As you said, it's Manchester Arena this Saturday, World War 3. Some tickets still available at frankwarren.com. If you can't make it down, as mentioned, it's live next week on Box Nation. I'd just like to open the floor to any questions, please. Don't look at your hands up.
Terry, would it be harder defending the title or winning it?
I thought depends on the opponent, doesn't it? And Zafiro is a good quality opponent. I think Magdaleno is a good opponent, but I don't know. On the night, I'm getting there, I was confident of beating Zafiro when I got in there with him. When I get him with Magdaleno, I'm sure the same will happen again.
Amazing man, and I'm just waiting for almost a month, and working here in Manchester with the Lee and the Rule. So it's amazing, that's the right moment, and I'm just waiting for that only.
Sonny, how
are you feeling here? Yeah, thank you. Thanks for giving yourself a tune. I'm really looking forward to that.
Give you a bit of info on what we'll be doing in the early stages of Virginia's career. You make him to fight on Saturday, then be out again on the 30th of October. Then we'll be fighting later on this year. There'll be six fights in the UK, and then we'll plan to do a show in Delhi in India next year. So it's going to be an interesting ride, definitely.
Joe, is this the first press conference you've ever
spoken? Oh, I'll spoke that later.
Yeah, no, really looking forward to it. Huge opportunity. Seen loads of Thompson. Good fighter. Switched southpaw, orthodox, coming in on a good run of form. But Liam Smith, he's got to announce himself on the world stage Saturday night. He's been one of the most underrated fighters in Britain for a long time now. Has British champion, and he's got to show what he's all about Saturday night. And we'll have a new world champion. And I'm really pleased with Terry Flanagan as well. I wish him the best of luck. And I can see Terry put a great performance on. I'm really pleased for him and Steve Mailer that they're headlining a show in Manchester, being in Manchester like myself. So good luck to the rest of you, and good luck and good health to everyone else fighting on the bill Saturday night.
Thanks, Joe. I think we get a reply from John's trainer, Dennis.
I have to say thank you, Manchester, having us here. I thought I could take thank you. Time to show me. You waited for a month for this. It's time to get this work in. So, no more talking. We just gotta go ahead and do our thing.
Game on, baby.
That's it.
Game is on.
That's all.
There you go. How much harder is
it
fighting on the road than having a world title chance at home?
Recently, I've been fighting all of my fights. None of my fights have been at home in Vegas. So, I mean, this is a little bit of a trip, but I learned a lot from my first fight when I had to travel all the way to Macau. You know, I adjusted real quick, and you know, a lot of people thought I won that fight, but here we are doing it again, and you know, I have no problem with it. I know that I have the right team behind me, and right next to me. So with that, I have the best trainer in the world that boosts my confidence way up there. His IQ is crazy high, and he has a lot of experience, so there's nothing, you know, we come here to fight. It's World War III.
How hard is that fight for you when you fought Martinez with the WBO
Superfight? What was that?
How hard is that fight for you with the scoring when you fought Martinez?
The scoring? It was a close fight. Honestly, I thought I did enough to win that fight, but I came out here with a better understanding of how it works to get that title. You have to take it.
Just ask Mark and Vito to say a few words from my guys.
Just want to thank everyone for being for us having to be here. I want to thank Frank and his father, the WBO, for mandating the fight. Box Nation. Just wanted to tell a quick thing about how John got here. I work with Artie Pulo and Banner Promotions, and a couple of years ago we resurrected a tournament that Artie started about 20 years ago called Boxino. And John, it's a tournament for contenders to kind of announce themselves, with the sanctioning bodies and whatnot. And John entered this tournament against guys, you know, with great records, undefeated guys. Guys are 15-1, 18-1. John entered the tournament literally on an hour's notice, and that just shows a lot about what he's all about. He entered, in an era where guys are looking to protect records and whatnot. John said, you know, I'll fight these guys. 1 hour notice, he enters a tournament. He beat a crafty southpaw, Ricardo Pinnell, in his first bout. The next bout, he beat a tremendous, undefeated Ukrainian kid named Stanislav Skorokhod. Really put on a boxing clinic that night. And in the finals, he knocked out the favorite of the tournament. Left it, you know, no doubt for anybody. And that just shows the type of fighter that we'll be seeing on Saturday night, you know, winning this world championship.
Hi, how are you guys? Well, I just want to let you know that with John Thompson, since the day we signed him, he's been fighting all top oppositions. Out of his last six fights, the records of his oppositions are 52-2. There's a difference quality of fighters, and he's a top A-class fighter. Liam has yet to fight the opposition that this man has fought. John's oppositions were Spahn, Andre Ward, Dominique Wade, Julius Jackson Benson, Errol Spence, Antoine Douglas. It's a whole different quality when you go into camp and you're sparring those guys day in and day out. Saturday, you'll see the difference between an A and a B fighter. That's all I can say.
The A fighter got knocked out against Frank Galazzo in two rounds. We'll see Saturday night. He can't hold a shot, and if you're going down, enough. And while you're at it, if Liam wins, I know that John's a really nice guy, a humble guy, and he goes good at drawings, but I'd love him to do a drawing of Liam with the world title belt. Thanks, John.
Time will tell.
Liam can't talk to himself. Okay.
Liam, anything to add to that?
No, just to touch on, you know, I don't think he's fought anyone really. He's had a couple of wins in the boxing, no tournament, but, you know, against people with good records, but. When you watch the fights, you know, they're the best fighters. They have a good record, but, you know, you watch them and, you know, they're not what the record says they are. And I've seen enough of John Thompson, I've seen him against them opponents. And, you know, I know he's not what it makes out to be. And I know my style will get to John Thompson, and I think I'll get to him sooner rather than later.
About the level of sparring
there? I just laughed soon as I heard Errol Spence. He's a southpaw. Errol Spence was a southpaw. Do you know what I mean? It's a bit just solid. Imagine him sparring Andy Ward. He's all started laughing when he said Andy Ward. Just leave it to him. He can spar all he wants. He's sparring. It's not sparring. It's sparring for a reason. Obviously, see if he can bring the sparring game to the fight on Saturday.
Christopher Lee Markham. What
do you think Frank would be on his performance a few weeks ago? How do you think your quite of a year contender out with him prepared you to get in with Frank?
Yeah, Frank done really well because, like a lot of people, I thought he had a puncher's chance, but I thought he was going to get taken out sort of mid-rounds. And unfortunately, got pulled out towards the end, but I thought he showed a lot of courage and he done well. So, my fight with Frank has put me in good stead because I had. After 10 rounds, being at a good pace. The fight for that was another championship 10 round fight, so yeah, it's probably a good set for this 12 round fight with Luke.
Tom, is this make or break for you?
Yeah, make or break. In my head, it's make or break. It's a fight that, you know, I need to win it. I want to still be able to fight more promotions. This time last year, Jack can't stop beating me. Frank's been fantastic with me for the past year, and it's a fight that. If I lose, where do I go from it? You know, like, I'm 31 years of age, so it's a fight that I've got to win, and I will win Saturday. I've had a 10-week time to come and put everything in. And I'm just looking forward to showing what I've been doing in the gym now, in the fight. Craig Evans is a tough fighter, I respect them, and it's going to be a great fight for the fans.
Craig, can you tell me what you learned from your fight against Scott Harvey?
Yeah, called the blocks too slow, and I got into the fight. I don't think he was a better fighter than me. He started too slow, and he pinched the fight, end of. Now I'm fighting Tom Stoker, good fighter, but I don't think he's going to beat me at all. Like, he's just going to, well, he said where he's going to go from there. I don't know, I think he better pack his bags.
Like I said to you before, the head-to-head said, he's only when he come back, so once I beat him on Saturday, he didn't come back well.
Give me a pack in your bags, yeah.
We're back.
That's what I got. He loves to swing it. I know.
Yeah. It's exactly on me.
Feels too sharp there.
That'd be a quiet fight.
Adrian, how big a step up is John Hayes for the panel that you fought before?
It's more of a step up for like 10 rounds and all that I've done before. More than I'd say John Hayes, you know. He's a good fighter. He's nothing better than what's already been there. So I'm looking forward to getting there and showing what I'm all about. It's about me, not about him.
Adrian, there's been a few comments made by you towards John's lifestyle. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
I just think in this game you need to respect the sport, you know, you need to live a good, clean, healthy lifestyle, and if you don't, it's going to come unstuck in the ring, so that's all I want to say about that.
John, do you care to respond to that?
Obviously, I don't know anything about me, you know what I mean? I don't really drink much. Whoever says they don't want to have a pint after a fight, tell them lies. Yeah, 10 boxers now don't like to have a pint after a fight, I'm one of them. But I train hard, I live a good lifestyle, and then Saturday night I'm going to show up my band.
John, do you feel your experience is important in this fight?
Yeah, definitely, you know, I'm under no illusions. Adrian's a good kid, he's a good skilled fighter, but I think I'm too good in every department and I think that's going to show on Saturday.
Jack, you're boxing another undefeated fighter. Is that your joy, taking on different challenges? What do you think Jack will bring to you?
Yeah, I'm just excited to get in there. Obviously, another undefeated fighter. These are the kind of fights I want going forward, fights that are interesting, that gets people's interest, so looking forward to getting in there.
Luke Blackledge, waiting for your chance to get on the big TV card. How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm feeling great. You know, the training camp's gone great. You know, this is a good step up for me. You know, it's a test. You know, Mark has done it the hard way like me, so this is going to be a dog fight. You know, this is a fight where I'm going to win, and he's not taking my belt off me.
I think this is a make or break fight for you.
Yeah, definitely, you know, this is everything, you know, that belt, you know, it's I've left the belt at my house, yeah. It's not, my title's not going nowhere. So, you know, Mark might as well pack his bags and fuck off home.
Adrian, you've been training hard for this fight. What have you
said? I know.
I've lost words.
Sonny Whitting, there's an expected audience of about 20 million people in India that are going to be watching the junior stages. How much of an impetus is there on you to score the party?
What do you mean by impetus?
I mean by how much of a big stage is this, how much of an opportunity is this for you?
Yeah, it's a big opportunity. I'm grateful for it, and this was one so far. So I want the other folks to go away, and I want these sort of fights. So.
Virginia, are you used to this sort of pressure?
No, man, there's no pressure. Because I already play like a lot of big Asian games, all the games, so it's like, feel like same, you know. You just go in the ring and just box hard. That's
it. Are you excited about the opportunity to open up the door of boxing in India?
Yeah, of course, man. It's going to be huge. Like, you know, people like love amateur boxing, but there's no pro career, so I'm like trying my best to do best in the UK. If I become like a world champion or WBO title, so it's become a huge in India.
Jimmy, is it exciting for you for your first televised fight?
Yeah, I'm just happy to get the opportunity to be on a big show. You know, I've come under the radar and just opened to break out the weekend.
Your panel's ace today, you haven't tried any more shots, man.
I hope it's up Saturday night.
It's not enough fun Jimmy a fight. If he doesn't turn up, we're big trouble. He's definitely an avoided fighter, Jimmy. So hopefully we'll have his opponent here. He is here. It's just that he's enjoying Manchester somewhere. Probably when he walks somewhere.
Yeah,
I've brought
some
students
to the UK. What do you know about Jack Maxwell?
I haven't watched his fight on YouTube, and I feel confident. He's a good fighter, and he have a great future, but I think it will start after next time.
Do you think you have the style to trouble him?
No, let's see.
John, is this where you got your nickname, the Apollo Kid?
Firstly, kid is spelled with two D's because I am not a child, but I am youthful at heart. Apollo comes from the gods Apollo, Zeus and Netho, who was the god, Apollo was the god of light, but he also was very talented as well as mine. Apollo comes from Apollo 11 in 1969, when Neil Armstrong landed on the moon. He said, one small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind. That said, this one person is opening up doors for everybody, not just himself. You know, and I'm not just doing this for me, I'm doing this for my family, for others that where I'm from also, to motivate and innovate.
Any more questions?
Why would I call you Big Thing?
That wasn't quite too yet. No, in a way.
You got seen his guns?
It's not quite as you know, clever as John Lancer, but it's because I was fat when I was a baby.
Liam, is there going to be a bit of bragging rights? You've been potentially first Smith brother
at the
world title.
That's so much bragging rights, but you know, it's going to be nice. I've seen them get the limelight of winning British titles first and Conwell title first and stuff like that, so I have to go and win it after them. You know, we haven't had the success of a world title yet, so you know, I'm looking forward to being the first one and seeing what the fuss is around me.
Yeah,
you've
got
grabs and
fight. Was there any race for you towards the world title between you,
because
you were the one who was expected to get there first.
What was that again?
You got brothers also boxed professionally. Was there sort of a race to get to a world title first?
No, not exactly a race. I knew that I'd get my opportunity. Top Ranks did an amazing job with me. My manager, Frank Espinoza, too. He's been pushing for this and. It's just, it's time, it's my time, you know. It's been a long run and I'm ready to take over the my weight class, so. No race, the race is here, it's the time is now.
Terry, how excited is it to be defending a world title at Manchester?
It's good, it's what I always have ever dreamed of from being a kid. From when I watched the internet 10 years ago. To think 10 years on and be defending my title, dream come true.
Is it different preparing as the champion? Are training been different or your mindset going to be different?
Well, I've always trained, stayed on and trained and always put 110% in anything I ever do, so yeah, it's just been the same as usual.
Sorry, with various rankings flying around, assuming who's the number one lightweight in Britain, because it's such a strong division domestically, do you think a win over Diego would put you right at the top of the tree out of our lightweight in this country, in that position?
I'm top of the tree now, I'm the number one with the world title. Like I said, Crawford, Mitchell, stuff like that, got the back in the sky, so the more I got left to the public, but yeah, I'm number one now.
What offers have been made to, I'm not going to name names, but some of the domestic rivals that no one wanted to know. So, we're lucky that Diego has got a set and got a plane to come over.
Tom, with you saying your fight against Craig to make or break, how do you think you're coping the extra pressure on yourself?
Pressure? I've pressured all my career, obviously, boxing in the Olympics and all the major tournaments and that as well. So. I will not let the pressure get to me, but that's, for me it's a fight that it's a must win, because we do go, you've got to be honest with yourself, if we don't win on Saturday, we do go, do you know what I mean? So, but it's a fight that I will win on the position of confidence, I'm going to be victorious, and that's the mentality I've got.
You're moving down your weight, so you
can
see the best of you now?
Well, I didn't struggle, like every boxer struggles to make weight. I like weight now, probably before 3 pounds over. I know it did show me weight, so I know I've had to struggle, I've had to diet, I've had to do a 10-week diet plan as well as my trainer, and I think I am generally a weight. I think I get in the ring at light welter about 10-5, where most light welters are getting 11 stone. So I think we'll be doing the lightweight, I'll be getting in around the same, but I'll be building strong, so yeah, I think we'll be strong for it.
Any more questions? Thank you very much for coming down today. It's looking forward to a top night on Saturday, not to see you all down there. There'll be all the guys are available for one-on-one interviews. And we'll see you Saturday. Thank you.
Right.